In my reading recently, I was reminded of how important the church at Thessalonica was to the Apostle Paul. He said at the end of chapter 2 in his first letter to them that there is glory and joy. He was forced to leave them, though, and like any good spiritual leader, is a little anxious about them as new believers. You see, the culture that surrounded the Thessalonians at the time had religion as a major part of it, but more of a pragmatic practice of religion to bring about good fortune if you practice things correctly. This would have put immense pressure on the young believers there, and the trials that the Thessalonian believers were facing could have convinced them that they had made a major mistake in abandoning their conventional religions in order to embrace Christianity. And because of his concern for them and their faith, Paul makes the decision to send Timothy to him to check on their status. Almost from the time that Paul had arrived in Thessalonica, the believers had experienced trials as a result of their conversion to Christianity. Especially in his absence, Paul knew they would experience hardships and trials. Now, by trials, Paul means the social and religious rejection, conflict, persecution, shunning, and even pressure new believers would experience in their conversion to a new and socially suspect religion. You know, these new Christians would not only worship the one true God and have to reject every other created God that was worshiped in their culture. You can imagine how their friends and family would have felt to now have someone completely change their lifestyle and reject the way their friends and family may still have been living. American culture at large is continuing a trend from Christian culture norm to a post-Christian culture. And as this happens, Christians who are living in accordance with the gospel of Jesus Christ can expect to encounter the kind of trials or persecutions experienced by Paul and the Thessalonians. If we are serious about obeying the teachings of Jesus and the words of the apostles, we can expect to find ourselves experiencing opposition and hostility, exclusion, loss, and more just because we're believers. You know, for us, this might look like losing a job for holding the company to proper ethics and morals at the loss of profit. Hostility towards you because you hold a view such as pro-life. Students being bullied and rejected because they won't go with the crowd. You know, though not in America yet, in some countries it's illegal to practice Christianity, and that can result in imprisonment, physical abuse, and even death. We continue to see increased hostility toward Christianity, but we must stand firm and draw encouragement to do so from accounts like these that are recorded in 1 Thessalonians. In the midst of trial after trial, the Thessalonians stood firm in their newfound faith. The reason we know that is because of the report Timothy brought back to Paul, recorded in 1 Thessalonians chapter 3, verses 6 through 8. Timothy has just now come to us from you and has brought good news about your faith and love. He has told us that you always have pleasant memories of us and that you long to see us just as we also long to see you. Therefore, brothers and sisters, in all our distress and persecution, we were encouraged about you because of your faith. For now we really live, since you are standing firm in the Lord. The Thessalonians resisted the enemy's temptations, and Timothy found them persevering in their faith in God and also found them upholding the proper standard of Christian conduct. For Paul and others, this was the evidence of the work of the Holy Spirit and of the reality of their new faith. Because of their standing firm, Paul and his friends were encouraged and they were energized. Paul, people, let alone Christians as a whole, we don't do well with suffering sometimes. But as we develop a theology of suffering that allows us to stand firm in our faith in the midst of suffering, our faith becomes a witness to others of the truth of Christ. In the Thessalonians' case, rejoicing in suffering allowed them to love others even when they were experiencing affliction. The result was a testament of God's power that encouraged others in their faith in God. And when we suffer in light of what Christ has done for us and the hope that we have in Him, it changes our perspective on everything and we become a testament to the power of Christ in our lives. We can support and encourage one another in ways that no other thing can. And when we support and encourage one another seeking the same things in Christ, we are less prone to wander and give in to the enemy and his schemes. Together, we can be ready when the time comes for the integrity of our own confession of Christ to be put to the test. When we see God at work, we need to acknowledge that. Not just in prayer to God, but also in communicating with those around us. Joy can be so contagious, you just have to be exposed to it. And just as Paul was rejoicing and relieved to see how God was working in the Thessalonians, others will rejoice and find relief when they see God working in those around them, We just need to make it known. I smile when I read verse 8 here in 1 Thessalonians 3. Paul says in verse 8 that now they really live because of the encouragement drawn from the Thessalonians. Instead of complaining or acting like the rest of the world does when we experience trials and suffering, we need to think of ways to support one another and those around us, proclaiming the transforming power of the gospel in our lives. Doing so will bring encouragement to those that we interact with. How can we support and encourage one another through the experiences we have in our lives? Be looking for ways to change how you deal with what life brings you each new day.